Yo, monkeys, it's time for DDP TV.
So high five.
Bang! That's right, it's back. Wrestling Weekly. I don't know about weekly, probably more like monthly because I'm still busy as hell because I am reconstructing YRG right now, and it's all going to fall under the auspices. Yes, DDP used the word auspices. I think I used it correctly. Who knows? DDP yoga. Because everybody calls it my yoga. How's DDP's yoga doing? By the way, I want to get to the wrestling part in a minute, but I got to get this off my chest. You know, no, it's not yoga. It's YRG. No. How's your yoga? People say, so how is DDP's yoga? So finally, I'm just beeping this show. Beep me on that, by the way. I'm gonna call it DDP yoga. And then when you see the logo coming out, boom, bam, it ain't your mama's yoga. So that's that's what I've been doing and trying to get back from Warner Brothers. That's why I haven't been talking about wrestling so much. But I got a lot to say about a lot of things that are happening in wrestling right now. And I want to go back to what the original idea was, where I talk about my career and moments. And as opposed to doing it chronologically, I'm just going to grab a match or grab a feud and talk about it for, you know, a one episode or a week or a month or whatever. In this scenario, I'm going to talk about the Sting match. The one that's on the very best of Nitro. Just happens to be, because of you, the second best-selling DVD in WWE of the last 2 years. That's pretty damn good. Only Cena beat that.
If you want some, come get some.
You want some? Fight.
TNT.
Come get some.
The WCW fans have spoken, and, you know, for WWE, it's about the cha-ching, you know, and that's a good thing. And everybody gets paid off of that, so that day, we all do good with that. So I'm excited about that, and that the response was so good. So I want to take one little segment from that best of, which you can also see on the very best of, because if you go to and if you made a mistake of going to what's it called? Netflix. Yeah, Netflix. If you made a mistake and go to Netflix and think you saw the whole package, you didn't. You saw a compilation of an 8.5 hour DVD down to 2.5 hours. And this match I'm about to talk to just happens to be on that. And it's the match with me and Sting. It's the night that I dropped the world title to Sting at the 9 o'clock hour. And then later on that night, won it back again from, I think I hit Nash with the cutter, I can't remember. But won it back the same night, was pretty cool. Let's go back to the match that I really want to talk about, is that match I had with Sting. I want to go way before that, back to about 95. I'm almost positive it was 95.
You got it right here, Renegade.
The most dangerous match in World Championship Wrestling.
And I had a match with Sting. And, you know, Sting was the man still back then. And I was lucky enough to actually get an opportunity to get in there with him. And we went about 10 or 11 minutes. And it was, up till that point, probably my best match, besides what I did with Mark Merrow. And I got a call from Michael P.S. Hayes, who I just happened to be doing On Demand with, probably in the next couple weeks. We're filming it on the 19th, and I'll be doing the Legends Roundtable, and Gene Okerlund, who I love, is going to be there doing it, and JR, I have so much respect for, and P.S. Hayes, I mean, he's like my brother, you know, when I came into WCW, he let me speak for them, him and Jimmy Jam, two of the best talkers ever.
What's going on?
Well, I tell you what in the hell is going on, I guess I found my man.
That was your man?
And I guess he found my left hand.
And he let DDP manager talk for them. So when I told P.S. Hayes that I was going to become a wrestler because they took me away from managing guys because the hair and the rap and the rings and blah, 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 no one's paid attention to a wrestler. That was you, Hayes, by the way. The bottom line is they said that I couldn't manage anymore. And I'll never forget being at Chattanooga, the Chattanooga Arena there, and they had this big blue screen there. It's, you know, everybody who ever walks back there knows like that. You remember that because you're getting ready to go through the curtain. And right before I went out there, I looked at Jimmy Jam and Michael, and I said, I'm going to go down to Power Plant. I'm going to start training. And Hayes said, what? I said, I'm going to stay. Won't let me be a manager anymore. I can only be fourth string color commentator. Next guy gets fired. I'm gone. And I said, I'm done. Yeah, I'm going to go down there. I'm going to learn how to wrestle. And Jimmy started laughing. But Hayes started laughing so much, he fell down, like, crying, holding his stomach. Ha, 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 ha. I mean, I was like, f*** you. And beep that, too. And walked right to the ring, did my entrance, blah, blah, blah. Now, let's fast forward. 4.5 years later, I have that match with Sting. Maybe it's 5 years later. I have that match with Sting, and I'm home that following my, Tuesday after Nitro. And I hear the phone ring, and the machine picks up, and I hear Michael's voice. So I run to the phone, and I know this is about Sting, so I'm going to get to that. And I pick up the phone, and I hear Sting start leaving, like, hey, Mike, P.S., what's up, man? He goes, God damn, son of a bitch, son of a kid. I go, Mike, you all right? You're right? You're right? Like, the son, yep. And I go, are you okay? Are you all right? He goes, Paige. He goes, you know, there's sometimes you're not supposed to pick up the damn phone. He goes, oh, man. He goes, I was going to leave you a damn message, but I guess I'm going to have to tell you. I seen your match with Sting last night. Everybody up here is talking about it. You really tore it down. He goes, I got to tell you, never have I been so happy to eat crow. You told me you were going to do it, and son, you're doing it. And it was, that was a big deal to me, because P.S. Hayes was like a brother. Michael was one of the guys I met early on who was a huge superstar that actually, when I got his number, we became friends, and I only hung out with him 2 days. He would actually call me back, and that meant so much to me. So to actually come into WCW and be actually managing him and Jimmy Jam, and then later on having, you know, him call me up and say how happy he was to eat crow was a defining moment. And it was probably one of the highlights of my personal career. So now let's fast forward 4 more years. And I'm the world champion. Wow. And I talked to Dusty about it. It was Dusty who came up with drop the strap, win the strap in the same night. Because they didn't want to take the strap off me, but they wanted to get ratings. And you know that quarter hour, if you look back in time, that this one, this match with Sting, that's on the very best of Nitro, was the last time WCW won the quarter hour. And that was a defining moment, I guess so too. So now let's go to the match. Anytime, like a lot of people say to me, you know, so who was your favorite opponent? And I had so many. I mean, from Canyon to Raven to Benoit, you know, to Sting to Randy Savage, you know. I mean, there was so many guys. I loved working with Hall and Nash. They were my boys, you know.
Toss the nuts to Paige. Paige. Nails.
Diamond cutter on Nash.
And a diamond cutter. 1, 2. Oh, my God. Paige is a world champion again.
But Stinger and I had a certain chemistry. Like, we just fit together. We work together. I'm going to smarten you up to a couple things in this match that we're going to have underneath the... if you go to... if you have that match, you can go back and watch it now. But if you're at ddptv.com and you've subscribed to that, then right under this, we're going to have the two sections of that match so you can watch that as well. But you'll never watch it as good as if you have the very best of Nitro. Sting was a little stressed that night, and I don't remember why, but in our business, guys will try to take advantage of other guys because it's a work, you know, and they'll just to make themselves look good, especially if they're not going over. And I don't remember why Sting was on edge around that time, but he was. And there's a point where in that match that is going beautifully, I mean, we got the people so good, we're going home, which means we got about a minute left. But I remember the ref going, Diamond, 5 more minutes. I go, what? 5 more minutes? So, I mean, we're like a minute, we're done. Because you got to be tight on your time. And I was like, okay, and you'll see me do some things, and eventually I'll end up on my knees. And I'm not supposed to do any of this. I grab Sting and throw him to the floor. He's like, what the hell are you doing? And he's going out. And you'll see us bing, bang. You can see the tension in his face, man. He's so pissed. Eventually, I go to choke him. And it's like a shoot choke. And I go, we got 5 more minutes. Block the punch. And that is by far my probably top 2 matches of all time. The other one being, of course, the one and only Randy Savage. Ooh, yeah, the Macho Man. God bless you, brother. Those two guys had a crazy chemistry with. And for Mach, I could be the babyface. But for Sting, I had to be the heel. So I always turned myself in that match, no matter what. Whether we were both up there as babyface or not, I'm going to take the heel spot because I know when it comes to DDP and Sting, it was that edge, you know, that he had a special over that period. And so looking back at that match, if you want to go there and check it out, that's all the sequences that got to that. And when I came up with that finish where I go for the diamond cutter and Sting grabs here, and then the second time he's supposed to grab here. But he does the old gear. I go, what are you doing? And then boom, boom, bam, and he hit me that finish. I almost broke my neck. Because that thing hurt like hell. That was like a shoot move.
The champion. Oh, now diamond cutter attempt.
No, he hooked the top rope.
Sting holding on.
But that's the behind the scenes of the DDP Sting match that is on the very best of Nitro. So hope you dug it. If you didn't, what can I tell you? Bang!